first and 10, wants it all. Deep over the middle for Winicky, has it inside the 10.
Still with it, Diana Powerball!
Ilfil Velez on the run, diving in the alley.
It's Alexander with a nice move, goes to the rim, got it to go!
Hi, friends, and welcome to the Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam. Great to have you with us this week as we look ahead to Conference Championship Weekend. The Big 12 Wrestling Championships will be in Tulsa, Oklahoma next Saturday and Sunday. We'll preview those with SDSU wrestling coach Chris Bono. We'll also recap the regular season finales for the SDSU men's and women's basketball teams, and we'll show you the brackets for the Summit League tournaments, which begin Saturday at the Denny Sanford Premier Center in Sioux Falls. But this past weekend, the Indoor Summit League Track and Field Championships were right here in Brookings, inside the beautiful Sanford Jackrabbit Athletic Complex. The men came an eyelash away from winning the team title. The women took third. Let's have a recap of the Summit League Indoor Track and Field Championships from this past weekend. Cross-country All-American Joel Reichow was named track MVP of the championship. He scored 25 points over three events, winning two. He finished first in the mile run, a time of 4 minutes, 16.63 seconds. He also claimed the 5,000 meter run. His time in that event was 14 minutes, 24.17 seconds. Brian Corter was field MVP of the event. He won the long jump, finished third in the triple jump, and was fifth in the high jump. Also on the men's side, Alejandro Sanchez broke the tape in the 800-meter run. He won that event with a time of 1:53.60. Rachel King set a school and facility record in the 3,000-meter run on Friday, and she followed that up by claiming the 5,000-meter title on Saturday. Her record time in the 3,000 was 9 minutes, 34.21 seconds, and Saturday's 5,000 time for King was 16:54.68. Carly Carper won the 60-meter dash in 7.57 seconds. The all-round athlete was also fourth in the 200-meter dash, and Carper finished seventh in the high jump. Zach Kuzman won the high jump as well for the men, who finished second as a team, just 2.5 points shy of a title. North Dakota State won with 192 points. The Jacks ended up second at 189.5. On the women's side, it was the Bison who won the team title with 226 points. USD was second with 206.5, followed by State in third with 128.
One more congratulations in order. That is to Rod DeHaven, named co-coach of the year during the Indoor Summit League track and field season. And what an event that was inside the beautiful Sanford Jackrabbit Athletic Complex. Men's and women's basketball saw their seasons wrap up this week, hosting Denver. The women on Thursday, the men on Saturday. And both look forward to the upcoming Summit League basketball tournaments in Sioux Falls. We'll recap the regular season finales. We'll preview the upcoming tournaments and more after this week's Inside State.
If I were to make my own SDSU ice cream, I'd probably make a birthday cake ice cream. A little bit of sprinkles on top with some cake batter in there, it'd be delicious.
My name is Amy Hankins and I'm from Belle Plaine, Minnesota. There's so many reasons why I chose SDSU. I wanted to go here because, you know, 3 hours isn't too far away from home, but it's close enough that I can get home when I want to. It has more of a small town feel to it, but it is still a big school. You can get to know anybody that you want to know and get involved in anything that you want to get involved in. Sophomore year, I decided, you know, I kind of want to break out from that shell a little bit. I decided to get involved in Greek life, and that really expanded my horizons on getting to know people, getting involved on campus. It's probably been the best decision that I've made coming here to SDSU. There's so many things to do for fun around here. Brookings is a growing community.
There's always something going on, especially around campus. There's usually movies, football games, basketball games, those kinds of things. Grabbing coffee at Einstein's with all my friends. We just like to hang out while we're doing homework. I'm just hanging out with friends on campus. I think SDSU is best known for our Jackrabbit Pride. During the football games and the basketball games, the whole sections are usually filled up with fans who are cheering for them. It's just great knowing that, you know, I go to a school where everybody supports our Jackrabbits.
Listen up, this is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew, this is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Welcome back to the Insider. The South Dakota State women's basketball team saw its regular season come to an end on Thursday, hosting the Pioneers of Denver on senior night. The Jacks got off to a bit of a slow start, but it recorded an impressive victory, all things considered, as they look forward to next weekend's Summit League tournament in Sioux Falls. Here are the highlights and Scotty Quaz's play-by-play from the regular season crescendo, a women's basketball victory over Denver.
Down the lane, back to Alexander in the right corner. Kara Young, top of the key to Giebert. Left wing is Ober now. Ober back door underneath. Kara Young to the hoop. Good for two. Shot no good on a forced layup. Loose ball by Ellie Thompson. Lexi Alexander dodging traffic through a double team. Kara Young right wing. She'll lean in drive. Back to Alexander. Right baseline for 10. Lexi, what a bucket. Good for two. Spittel trying to back in on Ober. Second effort up and under. Came up short off the rim. Alexander with a loose ball. Up to Giebert. Giebert left wing for three. Good. Madison Giebert makes it 7-0. Left wing, Palmer goes baseline, inside to Ober, up and under with a left hand, bank, glass, good for two. On the right wing now, Lexi Alexander, into the right corner is Sydney Tracy. Up top, Ober with a three. Ober up top to Vaiso. Vaiso goes Alexander, wide open right corner, three, doesn't take it, backdoor cut, Clarissa Ober. Outlet to Lexi Alexander, to the middle of the floor, nobody picked her up, layup, Lexi Alexander, good for two. 25-24, Denver has regained the lead on the Jacks. Left wing, Kara Young, dribble drive, bank on the glass. Good for two that time. Kara Young is giving the Jackrabbits a lead back. Up the floor, Lexi Alexander at the right wing to Kara Young. Swing it left wing, Madison Giebert right in front of us. Down low, second effort pass inside Ellie Thompson. Good for two. You might have heard the slap from Jesse Spittel on the hand. 3.5 to go in the quarter. Madison Giebert, second effort drives, attacks a double team. Palmer for three. Sydney Palmer with a three. Top of the key. A 4-point Jackrabbit lead. In the back court, Jack's trying to trap Simmental. Simmental late with the trap. Kara Young, long lead pass, got tipped, stolen by Giebert. Jack's got a 3-on-2. Giebert leans in, drives, layup on the glass, good for two. Giebert with a layup and a foul. She'll go to the free throw line. Shot for Denver off the rim, no good. Lexi Alexander with a rebound. Outlet to Kara Young, trailing down to four. Clarissa Ober for three. Good, Clarissa Ober. Posts post with back-to-back threes with Thompson and Ober. Alexander the crossover, Giebert top of the key. Swinging left side to Young, inside to Ellie Thompson. Thompson one-on-one on Ault. Kick out, Kerry Young for three. Three straight threes. And with 5 seconds to go, after the turnover by Denver, Lexi Alexander will bring it to midcourt. And after a close affair for three and a half quarters, your final score tonight, South Dakota State 78, Denver 54. The Jackrabbits end the season at 21-7 overall, 12-4 in Summer League play.
Congratulations to the South Dakota State women. That impressive victory to wrap up the regular season over Denver. The Jackrabbits secured the number 3 seed in the Summit League Tournament this weekend at the Denny Sanford Premier Center in Sioux Falls. In fact, let's have a look at how the brackets shake out for this weekend's tournament. It will start with action on Saturday. Top seed Western Illinois will take on the 8th seed Denver. The Leathernecks are the regular season league champs. Then the second game of the day on Saturday will feature the 2 seed IUPUI and the number 7 seed North Dakota State. Then on Sunday afternoon, the 3-6 and 4-5 matchups. It'll be USD and Omaha meeting Sunday afternoon at noon. And then the Jackrabbit women will take on Oral Roberts in the final opening round game on the women's side at 2:30 Sunday afternoon in Sioux Falls. The Jackrabbit women have dominated Oral Roberts in each of the 2 regular season meetings, winning decisively in Tulsa. And then with the Golden Eagles missing a couple of starters, a big victory on Think Pink Night in Frost Arena early in February. SDSU and Oral Roberts on the women's side, 2:30 on Sunday afternoon in the opening round of the Summit League Women's Basketball Tournament. We'll preview the men's tournament and have highlights of their regular season finale, a big win over Denver, after this week's Jackrabbit Legend.
A 2-time national champion wrestler at 134 pounds, this week's Jackrabbit Legend is Pat Dorn, presented by Legend Seeds. Dorn won 2 state championships and 161 matches at Adrian High School. That success continued on when he arrived at SDSU. In his freshman season, Dorn announced his presence with authority, finishing 3rd at the North Central Conference meet. The following year, Dorn went to the finals of the NCC championships, but failed to win the title. He made up for himself, however, at the Division II national meet. Dorn did not lose a match, becoming SDSU's 7th national champion. Dorn flirted with moving up to 142 pounds early in his junior year, but was back at 134 by January, and the results were there too. He avenged his conference championship loss the previous year, winning the NCC title in 1988. A week later, he repeated as the Division II national champion at 134, but he wasn't done. Invited to the National Division I meet, he lost his opening match. Undaunted, he won 3 straight in the WrestleBacks, placing 8th overall. The Jacks' first Division I All-American in nearly 20 years. He capped off his career with another national finish in Division II, taking 6th in the Division II national meet as a senior. Dorn earned 3 Division II All-America honors, in addition to that 1987 D1 accolade. He won 100 matches in his career, a select group of 12 Jackrabbits to reach the Century Club. Pat Dorn, a Jackrabbit legend. This Jackrabbit Legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties! And we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans. Agronomy, answers, yield.
Jackrabbit fans, we love it when you're along with us in the stands. Please remember to be positive at all games. It makes a big difference to hear your voices, but we want it to be a fun, safe environment for the fans around you and obviously the student athletes.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great. Welcome back to the Jackrabbit Insider, and what a difference a month can make. 32 days ago, the SDSU men lost at Denver, suffered an injury to a starter, and the Jackrabbits were in the cellar of the Summit League. But after yesterday's win over Denver, the Jackrabbits are the number 4 seed in this weekend's Summit League tournament, as SDSU ended the regular season by winning 6 of its last 8. Here are the highlights and the radio call of the Jackrabbits' decisive win over Denver to wrap up their regular year.
Dom backing down Daniel Amigo. Down to the right block. Middle of the lane, fadeaway 9-footer, good, and that is a new school record. Mike Dom with 5 points today, 748 this season, the most points ever in a season by a South Dakota State men's basketball player. 5-0 Jacks, all 5 by Dom, 15:40 in the first. Telenewsen changes that with a straight-on 3-0, but net. Up top, Dom looks left, swings it that way to King. King will drive middle of the lane, right wing Telenewsen wide open for 3, and it's good. They're within 2. Dom left wing fake of a 3, blows past Mackey on the drive, right-hand scoop shot, good for 2, and a foul on the Pioneers, Rosga. Rosga the rebound. Left side of the floor, middle of the lane, stripped on the way up by Orris, flattened the steal. He'll dribble left side of the lane to the rack, put it up off glass, no good. Howell tipped it and comes away with it. Left of the circle, flat, and he'll step back, shoot the 3, and it's good. 2:25 till the break, 34-22 State. Baseline left, it's Dom, spins, left hand hook, nothing but net. Shot clock at 13. Orris, right wing Hess, catches, shoots, and hits the triple. SDSU is up 20, 46-26. Pemberton all the way in, swatted by Telenewsen, who then went diving onto the far sideline. Telenewsen out top. Now to Orris, right of the key, Hess a pump fake. Now he'll pop an 18-footer. It's strong off the glass. Howell, the offensive rebound. Turn around, finger roll with the right hand, good. 5:35 Jacks. Bobbin on the drive, stripped. Stolen by Orris. He'll dribble down the lane. Feed King the trailer. In the lane, Severin, right wing Hess for 3. We're 5 minutes into the second half. Jacks lead at 58-37. Hess a pull-up 3. Top of the circle, good. Off to Orris. Front court, right wing, it's flattened. Orris up top, King. He'll attack middle of the lane. Jump pass left corner, Severin. His 3 is buried. The Jacks need NDSU to win in Omaha, and they need Fort Wayne to win against Western Illinois. Dom creates contact, throws one up with the right hand, falls to the deck, count the bucket, and a foul on Christian Mackey. Jacks a 74-56 lead. Severin, mid-left post to Dom. Back to the bucket against Amigo, across the lane, sweeping right hand hook, good. 30 for Dom. Denver ball, it's 86-64 Jacks. And a post-game show, TJ Otzelberger, AJ Hess will join us. King the steal, all the way in, two-hand jam. SDSU wins 7 of its last 10 to close the regular season. The Jacks finish league play at 500 after a dominant 88-64 victory over Denver on senior day at Frost Arena.
An impressive win for the Jackrabbit men over Denver, and they'll turn around and play them again on Sunday night in the opening round of the Summit League tournament. In fact, let's have a look at all the pairings as Saturday and Sunday, the first round in the Summit League men's basketball tournament. The top seed is the University of South Dakota, and the Coyotes will take on the number 8 seed Western Illinois to open up the men's tournament on Saturday night at 6 o'clock. North Dakota State, a very challenging portion to the bracket for the 2 seed. The Bison have lost in the last 3 weeks to all 3 of the other teams on their side of the bracket. NDSU will take on the Jaguars of IUPUI in the 2-7 game on Saturday at 8:30. Then Sunday, a pair of games in the Summit League men's quarterfinals. The Jackrabbits take on Denver. Again, those two teams split regular season meetings. Denver winning by 9 out in Denver in January. Then that dominant SDSU win we just chronicled on Saturday. That'll be a 6 o'clock tip on Sunday night at Omaha and Fort Wayne, and which should be a high score
scoring affair wrap up the opening round on the Summit League men's side of the bracket at 8:30 on Sunday night. But once again, there'll be a doubleheader for the Jackrabbits. The women will play at 2:30 on Sunday afternoon, and then the men take on Denver at 6 o'clock Sunday night at the Denny Sanford Premier Center in Sioux Falls. We look forward to seeing you out in Sioux Falls and supporting the Jacks in the Summit League tournament. The SDSU wrestling team will be competing at the Big 12 Championships in Tulsa, Oklahoma. We'll preview their trip down to Oklahoma with head coach Chris Bono after this week's Jackrabbit Hot Seat.
I'm Abby Murphy. I'm from Maxburg, Iowa. I'm a physical education major, and I play softball. My favorite TV show would have to be Grey's Anatomy. I really enjoy, pretending that I think I am a doctor, but I'm really not, and I never will be. So I enjoy watching that show. My favorite food would have to be a New York strip because I love steak. I play softball because it helps me to learn more about life and realize that everything in life isn't always fair, and that in softball, the only thing that is fair is between the foul poles. If I didn't play softball, I think I would take a lot more naps, and I probably wouldn't do hardly anything but go to class. I think the best part of Brookings is the hometown feel and how it's such a small community, but the community really supports all the athletes on campus and goes to sporting events. The reason I chose SDSU was because of the hometown feel, like I said, and how the coaches really made me feel a part of the team right away when I came on my visit, and how the campus is small enough, but it's big enough that I, can still walk pretty far. And then it's small enough because I still know a lot of people, and I really like my major too. And talking with the recruits on my visit, it helped me to choose here too.
To me, sustainability means being able to feed the world in the future.
We need to produce more with less.
It's knowing that our soil is going to be in better shape this year than it was the year before.
We need to stop erosion at the top of the hill, not at the bottom.
We find that we can merge sustainable practices with profitability.
It's about caring for the land.
It's about passing it on to the next generation.
It's about doing the right thing. I have a responsibility.
For the people of South Dakota.
To feed the world.
The future of farming is very bright.
I'm Jeff Lochner.
Steve Halverson.
Al Muron.
This is Farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
The Insider continues with a look at the South Dakota State wrestling team. Five Jackrabbits are ranked in the top 20 as the Big 12 championships are right around the corner. And you look back from the beginning of the season to now, it's been an impressive 2016-17 campaign for the SDSU wrestlers led by head coach Chris Bono.
They've done a great job, and you know, we knew we had a pretty good team coming into it. We have, you know, five individuals we knew that would be, you know, really good. But the development of our other five have been what I'm kind of really happy for. And these guys are wrestling at their best now. And from August till now, the improvement is almost to the maximum. So excited to see what they can't do.
The Jacks have had their best year of the Division I era, not only with the success on the mat, but also in drawing a record number of fans.
I want to say it's a lot of the marketing, a lot of the promotions we're doing, what we're doing in the community. But you know, the bottom line is you know, we're winning a little bit. We're ranked, and we have great opponents, big schools that are coming in here. So I think our fans really like to see that. Plus, you know, there's a little sideshow that goes on in the corner, I think, of that these fans are really enjoying. We love it. We love our fans, and it's been one heck of a year.
Next weekend, the Big 12 Championships will emanate from the BOK Center in Tulsa, Oklahoma. The Jacks are the only team in the Big 12 this year who has actually wrestled every other league squad, which Bono feels is a big advantage for next weekend.
But, you know, our guys have beaten guys from Oklahoma State. You know, our guys have beaten guys from Wyoming and Iowa State. So it's no surprise to me. It's nothing new to me. Our guys are capable of being All-Americans and national champs, and, you know, they've got 2 weeks here to prove it.
Sometimes outsiders can have a small-town mindset about this program, that they may be intimidated when they face top competition. Well, if recent history is any indication, that is anything but true.
When guys were still transitioning here from the D2 days to the D1 days, and when I first got here, they were a little afraid. You know, and we lost some matches to guys because of the color of their singlet, but not anymore. Our guys really love it when they get a top-quality opponent. And, you know, the more you wrestle them, the more you beat them, the more your confidence grows.
Five Jacks were ranked by the coaches panel this week. Seth Gross is 27-1 at 133 pounds. He's number two in the nation. 197-pounder Nate Rodert, the junior from Spearfish, is eighth. He sports a season mark of 19-5. The Kosher brothers are both ranked. Alex is 24-6 this year and ranked number 14 at 149, while David is 15th with a 20-7 record at 174. And Luke Zilverberg is 22-6 and is 18th in the country. This is a confident group.
They know the work they've put in. They know we worked harder than anybody in the country. The best part about it is they've had results. You can say what you will about working hard and doing this and doing that, but if you don't have any results, there's still a little doubt in your mind. These guys have had results. They've won. They've lost, and they've gotten better, and then they've won. So they've got a little confidence heading into this Big 12 tournament.
And Bono says his mantra to the team is simple: go get what you deserve next weekend.
Yeah, you know what we say whenever there's score being kept? We always want to have one more point. And so go take what's yours. That's exactly what we're saying. This is your time, and you know, what you think you deserve is what you're going to get. So go take what you deserve and go take what you want.
So good luck to the SDSU wrestlers competing at the Big 12 Championships in Tulsa next weekend, and to the SDSU men's and women's basketball teams, who will be opening up play Sunday in the Summit League basketball tournaments at the Denny Sanford Premier Center in Sioux Falls. Now, next week, due to the timing of those games on Sunday, we won't have highlights. We'll have season recaps of the men's and women's teams. Plus, we'll have conversations with the Summit League commissioner, Tom Duple, and much more. So we look forward to having you back here next week. And again, we hope to see everybody out in Sioux Falls. And for all of us here inside our Yeager Media Center studios, I'm Tyler Merriam, and we'll see you back here next week on the Jackrabbit Insider.